See if the headshots still look like you or if it's over airbrushed. I cannot tell you how many times I've seen headshots where it's so gorgeous, but it looks nothing like the actor in real life. Hi, welcome back. This is Jo. If this is your first time here, welcome. I'm a Chinese actress living in Hollywood North, chasing the big dream of getting that golden Oscar. So for the third video of How to Start Acting series, I will be talking about how to get the perfect actor's headshots. Now, just a heads up, because of COVID-19, most photographers are still operating for shoots with certain implemented safety policies. So make sure you look at their policies and communicate with your own safety needs. And just remember, safety first. Now, the headshot. It is the most important first impression marketing material for an actor. Most important. When you submit your package to an agent and eventually a casting director, you want them to look at your headshot and say, yes, I want to represent this actor. Bring that actor in. Your headshots will also be competing with hundreds of other headshots seen by agents and casting directors on a single day. You want to stand out. You want to look professional, so you must have a perfect headshot that is high quality, professionally taken, beautifully photoshopped, and definitely, most definitely, not from your phone. The price range of professional headshot sessions can range from $300 to $1,000, depending on how many photos you decide to purchase, whether you wish to hire a makeup artist, and how long you're going to book the sessions. A typical headshot session is around 2 hours. It can be outdoors or in a studio with 3 to 4 outfit changes and 3 to 4 edited final photos. Speciality. Find a photographer who specifically takes actors' headshots within their craft. Not every photographer understands what the industry standard is for actors' headshot, such as framing, lighting, and background. They may be more experienced in high fashion or glamour or landscape photography, so the work that they're going to produce will look very different from the industry standard. Now here's an example of a headshot I had taken by a fashion photographer and my actor's headshot. As you can see, the lighting and editing style is very different. Research. Check their portfolio for their work, which most professional photographers will have on their website. Research their reputation and reviews. See if a lot of actors actually go to them for headshot sessions. More often than not, your local acting school will have suggestions of headshot photographers that they work with. Before you go to the shoot, figure out the character types and age range you have to look for. This will help you drastically while picking out your outfits and your makeup style if needed. Now remember, it's not about how old you really are or what kind of characters you want to play. It's about what you have the look for, where a casting director would look at you and immediately want to see you audition for a certain role. If you want a fun way to figure this out, I actually made a video on how to find your character type quickly, which I will link in the description down below for you. Now, outfits. When you are choosing your outfits, pick clothes that are simple, without props or decorations or blings that will take away the focus from your face to your clothes. Your clothes are meant to accentuate your look, not take the attention away from you. Earth tones, gemstone tones are all good colors to go for. Choose your outfits that are appropriate for the type of characters and age range that you can play. If you have a look to play law enforcement, don't actually shoot your headshot with a full police department outfit. That will heavily limit your roles, and it's just way too much. Instead, maybe wear a dark blue shirt and have your expression to be very lawful and assertive. Studio versus outdoors. Before your shoot, communicate with the photographer and take into consideration whether you're shooting indoors or outdoors. If you're shooting indoors, take into consideration what color of the background you'll be shooting in front of. So for example, if you are shooting in front of a gray backdrop, don't wear gray clothing. All of this can be easily communicated with the photographer you've chose to work with. Makeup and hairstyle. This is one of the biggest areas where I see actors make mistake of. Casting directors want to see that you look exactly like your headshots. So if you naturally have straight hair and you will go to auditions with straight hair, Do not curl your hair for your headshot. If you're planning to dye your hair in a couple of days and will be going to auditions with that hair color, your headshots has to be the exact same hair color. Don't shoot your headshots before you dye your hair. In terms of makeup, don't go overboard and start changing your features like what contouring does. Keep it natural. You want to look like yourself on your best day. So typically you can pick 3 to 4 final edits in a headshot session. The photographer will send you all of the raw images that you've shot during your headshot session. Then you pick the 3 to 4 photos you want, and the photographer would typically send you back the final photos in a week. Things to keep in mind: film and TV versus commercial. A tip to keep in mind is that you will end up using 2 main types of headshots during your submissions: film and TV and commercial. Now the main difference is the expression smiling versus smizing. Here's why. Most commercials require the actor to look charismatic and personal in order to sell a product, which results in more smiley headshots. Whereas film and TV productions are looking for actors who look like whatever role they're casting for. So definitely pick one where you're smiling and looking perfectly professional and charismatic for commercial auditions. Then pick one where you are smizing, where you look like you can be molded into different characters. Now, this is perhaps the most easily overlooked step of this entire process of headshots. See if the headshots still look like you or if it's over airbrushed. I cannot tell you how many times I've seen headshots where it's so gorgeous, but it looks nothing like the actor in real life. Either a mole would be missing or the headshot would be half the size of what the person actually is. Most actors would look at the photo and understandably be very happy with how they look and be like, oh my god, I didn't know that I'm actually so pretty. But this is a major mistake. It will heavily, heavily backfire. Think about it. Once an agent and a casting director sees your headshot, they would inevitably look at your demo reel or you in person. Have you ever dated somebody who looked nothing like what they looked like on their photos online? Did you enjoy that? Did you like that? How often did you give that person a second chance? Yeah, think about that. Last but not least, keep your headshots updated. Always. And the frequency of how often you need to update your headshots highly depend on how frequently you change your look. And that can depend on your age. If you're growing as a teenager, then you would look very, very different every year. It also means weight changes, haircuts, hair dyes. If you had some work done in your face even. It's Hollywood, no judgment here. Keep your headshots looking like yourself and you're good to go. That's the video for today. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments down below. If you like this video and you would like to follow me on my journey paddling through into Hollywood with my tiny T-Rex arms, click like, subscribe, and a notification button, and I post videos on Fridays. I'll see you next time. Bye! You've just decided to continue pursuing acting after understanding the basic structure of the acting industry. What is the next step? Acting training! One question you might be asking: do I really need acting training, or can I just get an agent and wing it? Because